Yes, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to round 16 of the Apex Online Racing League in Malaysia, Sepang. We've got a full grid today. We also have a special guest we might have a special guest, I don't know. I'll find out. Alex Gillen has joined us for one race only. He normally comes in for one race each year. This is the race he's decided to join. Of course, a three-time undefeated champion in AOR, meaning he's been the championship leader and title holder for 3 years in a row, and he has never been beaten over a season during his time in AOR. Anyway, on board with Nuka. He's just on his outlap at the moment on the soft compound tyres. I forgot to have a look what tyre compounds we will be using today. I think it's the softs, mediums and hards, if memory serves me correct, here at Malaysia. Track is 5.5 kilometres, 3.4 miles. Full throttle for 45% of a lap. The longest flat out section is of course a pit straight, which is a kilometre long. The pole time today, we should be seeing about a 1:33.8 or maybe a low 34 for pole. Going to strategy later on. Anyway, I need to try and figure out all my camera stuff as well. Obviously, King Kodiak is not here today, as you already aware. He's unfortunately got family commitments. Here's Marco. I know he's been doing a lot of practice for this track. I was talking to him earlier on, and he says he was in the low 1 minute 34. I think a 34.2 is his PBs currently. Be interesting to see if he can improve on that. Hasn't had a win this season. Quite unusual for him. This time last season, he was already the champion. In fact, no, I think he was a champion in Russia this time last season. It was, but obviously Russia's been swapped to the beginning of the season. Beginning of the calendar, it's only round four. He is on a flyer, however. Afro is also on a flying lap. In terms of sector times, any of you are interested, sector one, I mean overall, the sector times I've got are going to be quite wrong, but it's probably about, you're looking at a 24 for the first sector, probably a 32 second sector, and a 1:39 third sector. Well, I hope we're going to have a different winner as well, Massa. I mean, Tirano has won, I think, 90% of the races this season. Yeah, he's won all the races but three, which is quite a record. If he hasn't won, non-runners picked up the points. So, we've only got two race winners at the moment on the grid. Let's hope that will change by the end of today. We've seen a 23.7. I think that's fairly competitive. Alex has already set a fast lap. I wonder what lap time he ended up getting. Let's just go to the top. Right, Marco set a 34.8. He can improve massively on that. He's on the soft compound tyres. Gillen is on the medium compound tyres. Look like a non-runner set a competitive time on the medium compound tyres. 35.4. All the guys will be setting their fastest laps now. Let's go to someone who hasn't yet set a lap time. Let's have a look, see if... what's his name? I forgot his name now. Tirano is on an out lap. No, he isn't. Let's keep focus on Alex. He's in the second sector. If I get my bearings right, how do I change? Ah, here we go, right. Last corner, very difficult trying to hit the apex. It's about third gear through the whole of that complex. Used to be second with the V8, but in the V6 hybrid era. obviously they're using third. He's now probably going down to second or third gear here. See if he's wanting traction. No, he's coming into the pits. Wow, he's obviously been practicing because his pit lane entry is superb. Let's have a look at non-runner. Let's see what he's doing. I imagine this is in lap. By the look of his sector times, yes, it is in lap. See if we can see someone on a flying lap. Well, Afro is definitely not on a flying lap. So, BBIS. I'm not sure who he is. Maybe he's here for one-off. He's in the Force India, teamed up with Alex. Let's just go through the Constructors and Drivers' Championships. Hopefully I can get it right. Alright, there you go. Should be able to see the Drivers' Championship on the top left of your screen. So, obviously, Tirano's already got the championship. He's on 184 points ahead of the next driver. He's on 351 points after him. Is non-runner 184 points behind, which is quite crazy. When you have Fizzy, he's 131. And we've got Marco, only 107 points to him. Nick B, he's moved up quite a lot in the last few races. He had a few unlucky races around mid-season. Hungary and Silverstone, he got an 11th and a DNF. He also got a DNF last. No, he didn't get a DNF last time. Last time he got a 4th after his string of bad luck. So he's right on the money again. We've got Nooker, Merrick, Kalon, Mini Black, Chicane, Nally, Massachusetts, Randrop, The Lowell 12, Ryan, L83. He was finally able to get a bit of a break. He got 6th place. He was looking quite good though at one point. He was up in 4th place. So hopefully he'll be able to improve on that today. Saying he's racing, I think he is. I haven't seen him though. Let's have a look on Alex. We're not going to have much of a time this season to take a look at him. Then you've got Nick No Name, then O'Darn, then Afro, the Lossy, and the new driver, which is EZN92. He got a points finish for his debut race last time out, which is not bad at all, especially in split one. I think we've got quite a full grid. Let's have a look how many drivers we have. But it must be close to max. Yeah, we've got 18 drivers today. Obviously, I'm not including myself. Let me run you through the lap as Alex takes his flyer. So, coming up into turn one, I'll just take off the drivers. Coming into turn one, braking as late as possible, probably about 100 metres, 75 I think he broke. Now, you want to get quite a late apex, as Alex has done there, and another late apex here, and that allows you to get the power on for the second and third corner. Using second gear, I think I would have used third, but he's a very quick driver, very experienced driver. Braking at about 60 metres, very high speed right-hander. You can take this flat out if you have the right setup. You should be able to hear it flat out. You might have a little lift off just here. Yes, he does. That's just to get the car to turn in. Then you've got this double right-hander, really difficult to get right. You normally double shift down into fourth and the power up. Now you coming up, we've got this downhill sharp left hand almost chicane. It's very easy to lock up. He has had a bit of a lock up, but it's not too bad. Onto the long right hander, that leads into another long right hander into third gear on the power early. Now coming up to the almost lost it, coming up to the penultimate corner. Now it's quite difficult to get your braking right. You want to go wide, then just get the apex quite late so you can get on the power as early as possible coming down the straight. Now a lot of the drivers will be about 1 to 2 meters away from the apex of this final corner. It's on a bit of a camber, so it does make it quite a bit easier. Alex has chose to go right into the apex, gets on the power nice and early. It's going to be a 1:35.4. It's an okay lap for the soft compound tires, but you might have another go. as his tires probably wouldn't have been fully up to temperature. Let's have a look closer to the front of the field. Marco's quite competitive in first place. He's just set a fastest lap time. Was that a 34.4? Now, I haven't seen Tirano set a time yet. He might not be driving. I'm just going to check that Ryan is also racing. I know he has had wheel issues. Did I see his name? I'm not sure. I know he's in the chat. No, it doesn't look like he's racing, unfortunately. I know he has had wheel issues. I hope they haven't came back to haunt him. Well, Marco set his fast lap. He's going to be coming in. Not much point keeping an eye on him. Let's have a look at Nooker. 25.9. That's not very fast first sector, so I am... No, he's definitely on in lap. Marek, he's been one that's been really surprising. He's set a 23.5. That's not too bad at all, actually. If we compare that to Marco's best, it's 20. Yeah, it's definitely faster. In fact, it's like the fastest we've seen. Well, it's definitely on the money. I'm just trying to get my orientation correct. Right, he's coming up to that chicane downhill. Possibly a bit of a lockup. Hopefully not. Sometimes the camera deceives us and it's not giving us the correct information. 204 miles per hour is the top speed of these cars around this track. I think it's about, what is it, 345-ish kilometers, I think. Well, that looks like quite a nice line. Don't think he hit the apex, so he's obviously going to have some good speed now. I think he set a 34 is quite a competitive second sector. Is he going to be one to hit the apex? No, he's miles away from the apex. He's in the pits. That didn't seem like a too bad a lap time, though. So I think that would have been quite competitive. He's N92. His debut race last time out. Let's hope he can improve on that 10th place. It's very difficult to just come in midway through a season and suddenly be quick. Although I've always started from the beginning in my AOR career, from the beginning of the season, I have had times where, you know, I've had to miss the first couple of races just due to either family issues, holidays, something like that. And, you know, you come in round three, everyone's already up to speed. I mean, And you always lag behind a little bit. I mean, it's probably not going to happen, but if we had another season on F1 2016, I imagine the game will be out at that time. It might be a mini-season. Oh, a little bit wide. He's lucky not to lose the back end of a car, though. If the speed from one season to the next is quite phenomenal. It's about a second difference in qualifying around some tracks. He came into the pits. Lol is... he's just at a fast lap. Tirano is out. We will make sure that we check on him. There's only 3 minutes to go. He's banking on a quick medium lap time run. Let's have a quick look through the grid. Marcus currently got the pole. The best possible time at the moment is a 34.2. Now, apparently, Tirano's fastest lap at the moment during practice is a 33.8, which I believe he set today. So, should be quite exciting to see what kind of time he can get. If he sets his PB, he's going to be 4 tenths ahead of the next driver, or at least 4 tenths anyway. Quite a few drivers, though, in that 1:34, an extremely close grid from second down to fifth. Marek showing his pace again, as always. Of these drivers, Fizzy is apparently on a flying lap. I think he just finished his lap time, though, last time we saw him. Let's have a look. No, he possibly is on a flying lap, actually. He's going very, very quickly up to the last corner. The Ferrari, I can only assume, is Tirano. Let's have a quick... Oh, shit. Let's have a quick look. Is that Tirano? No. Well, yes, it is Tirano. Is he coming to the last corner, breaking nice and late? Is he coming into the pits? No, he isn't. He does miss the apex. That's what I will do. It allows you to get much better traction, especially in the lower gears. And it's a 34.8. Not too bad. Not amazing, though. Now, let's have a look at... I'm not very good with names today. Tirano. Now, his fastest lap was a 33.8 on the soft compound tyres. So, I'm not sure what the time difference is, but I would imagine it's about 0.4 of a second, which I mean, he could still, in theory, get pole if he is four tenths of a second slower. I have no idea what that symbol means, Ryan, but GG to that. Well, I'm not sure if Alex is going to be hangover. He might be. No, he might be pretty pissed, actually, at 8 p.m. But we don't know. And that's the exciting thing with Alex. Because if he crashes someone out, he can hardly get banned or removed from the league because he's not in the league. So hopefully he's going to provide some extremely entertaining drunk driving with him and Tirano's Tigger. I would just love that. That would just be fantastic. Alright, Tirano is coming towards the end. He's really quick. 32.1 is not bad at all. I think it's... a bit of bad traction. I think it's going to be a 35. No, it is a 34. His teammate is ahead of him. Oh my god, no way, please. I actually hope Marco is in pole. No, Nick B has just gone faster. No way. Nick B has gone faster. That is it. Tirano... Ooh, in theory, he could do another lap. Is he going to be doing another lap? No. He's not. Tirano's not on pole. Awesome. That's absolutely awesome. Right, we are now in this view here. I can't do anything. Can't go back to the view we're once in. I'm just going to... Just sending a link on King Kodiak's channel for anyone there. Oh. I wonder if Marco increased his lap. His time, 34.3. He did. Amazing. Great lap time by Marco. Your ex-Apex Online champion, Apex Online racing champion, is in pole. Nick B's obviously not on a flying lap. Tirano definitely is not. Marek is. He's still on a fast lap. Let's see what kind of time he's able to set. It's every time I tab out games, sorry about that, guys. Have a look at the constructors. In fact, no, it's covering up the time. He's going to get some slipstream from Nick B. He's half a second down. That was at the last sector split, which is quite late on in the lap, relatively. Still got a few complex corners after that, though. And... Wow, Mark improved. He's only 0.3 behind. Tirano is in fourth. That looks like everyone. That is everyone setting their lap times. Gonna have a quick look. Someone went P2 or 1. I think the person who went P2 was Nick B. I believe Massa. Yes, I am. I'm on my own today. King Kodiak, unfortunately, is not able to make it due to family commitments. He might be with us later on. It's all very much depends. It just depends, really. nothing we can do. I'd like to get a table so we can see the full results. I'm going to have to quit and then rejoin. And then hopefully we will be joining on the formation lap. Here we go. No way. Afro went pole. Just ahead of Marco. He's going to be really annoyed with himself. That's one place closer to Toronto. Well, quite an exciting grid though. I mean, Alex all the way down in 12th. Obviously, he has not been on the game in a very long time. And 0.8 of a second in split one is extremely a small margin. Alright, I'm going to leave a session. I will mute my mic and I'll be back very shortly, guys.
Channel switched.
Thank you.
You.
Was it a fun watch?
Thank you.
Tirano was on the medium, right?
Yeah. Like everyone.
Oh, that intro is so nice.
Frame drop central. Will do.
Yeah, it set the heart higher for me. I can't change it. Why I cannot change it?
Hello? That's weird.
Right then, here we go. I forgot to mute my desktop, so you had some intense driver talk. Well, it wasn't that intense, actually. Well, Ryan, I wish you did get pole. That would be really good to see. Her pole since your Xbox days. Gosh, that was a long time ago. So, FO ended up getting pole. You did a good job. I wonder what is... I mean, he's right at the bottom of the championship. He's an 18th in the championship. Although he did join in Hungary, he got a DNF. His only other points finish result was in Belgium in the wet and dry conditions. And he only got a 7th. I say only. 7th is still a good position, but... Yeah, I imagine the odds on that would have been quite high. 683 meters down to the first turn. So, should be quite close. Pit lane lost time as well is about 22 seconds, 19 if you're doing a drive-through. Hopefully none of the drivers will have to do that. A fairly varying strategy though, so 2 or 3 stop. You might even be able to make the one or three stop work. So, you know, there's a choice of three strategies, especially with all the new tyre compounds. Right, let's have a look at the front, and I'm going to change my camera view. However I do that. Right, here we go. I think it's that one. We'll find out soon. Oh no, hang on. It's probably F2, isn't it? You can have an onboard like that, and then it's F2 to go. Yo, look at that. I'm amazing. Right, here we go. Lap 1 of 28. Let's hope I'm not starting. Here we go. Lights out. 4 lights, 5 lights, and away we go. Afro's got a good start. There's a lot of drivers wide. You can see the Ferrari is quite close to the Mercedes. Is he going to try and get around the man around the outside? No, the manner of Nick B, who's got second place off Marco. In fact, the Red Bull of Marek might be getting quite racy as well. Oh, there's been a collision, though, with the Red Bull of... Oh, no. Oh, dear. It looks like Marco and... who else is that? Oh, gosh. That's awful. Marco and Marek. Oh, Marco's left a session. Wow, that's really, really disappointing. It looks like Nick B's got the lead. Tirano's in second. Was that Afro who went out? No, it wasn't. He's still in third. He's in the other Red Bull. But that is really, really unfortunate. Got the McLaren there. That is Marek, who Marco had the incident with. He can still rejoin, but... he's going to be a very long way behind and probably with damage. That's not what we wanted to see, but oh well. Nick B is leading from Tirano. He's 0.2 behind. DRS won't be active yet. It'll be active next lap. Fizzy's quite high up as well. I forgot where he qualified, but I'm going to say he's coming under pressure by Nooker. And if Nooker stays around the outside, all he has to do is hang on, and he's going to have the inside line and always definite overtake. And that is move not yet done. Very close between these two drivers. Fizzy has an Alonso-style helmet, I've noticed, from his Renault days. And it looks like, ooh, Fizzy's had a bit of a moment there. He's allowed Nooker past. He's also allowed, is that Kalon? I think it's Kalon. I forgot who's in the manor. Let's go back up to front of the grid with Tirano following Nick B. Afro's behind him, then Nooker, then Kalon, then Fizzy, then non-runner, Alex Gillen. He's up in 8th place. That's... four positions higher than he started. He started in 12th place, just 0.8 seconds behind, a very close grid. Well, the driver's obviously been practicing. Oh yeah, see my mouse, there you go. Fizzy's having a go on Kalon. Let's see if he gets it. He's not going to have DRS on this lap. It has said two laps in a row, which is strange. Hopefully it changes to 3 any second now. It'll be annoying if it doesn't. And it has changed. So, DRS this lap then. He's got the Williams, and is he going to overtake Kalon? Nooker did a very similar move on him the lap before, and he's got the apex. If he gets a traction, it could be moved on. However, it looks like... Oh, there's a little bit of contact. Kalon almost lost it, but Fizzy's still in luck. Breaking for the 5th corner, and Fizzy seems to be under pressure from the Williams of non-runner, who is our other sort of championship winner this season. On and around the outside of this double right-hander. That's moved up. That's impressive. Hello, a bit further up, we've got Nooker and Afro and Tirano and Nick B. Now, Nick B's very fast. He's had a couple of unfortunate issues. Hockenheim comes to mind, where he made a very small mistake and he barely even touched the barrier, and that was his race over. However, Tirano hasn't overtaken him yet. Whether that changes with DRS, I mean, Tirano's really, really, really close. It looks like Tirano's probably going to have the move done. And yes, he is. Will Nick be there outbreaking? He just has to be careful that he now doesn't lose a position to Afro. Now, I think is he going to have DRS? No, he isn't. There's only one. Oh, there is two detection zones. I'm surprised he hasn't. I think there is. No, there isn't. There is actually only one detection zone. That's at just between turn 12 and 13. So it's it's quite punishing, especially when you have about, I don't know, 1.8 kilometers of throttle to defend, and the driver behind has the DRS. However, Afro is behind Tirano. Oh yeah, Gillen is on the hard compound tyres. Makes me wonder if he... Yes, you're right, I didn't notice that. I hope that is correct. Let me check the race director. There's a few drivers on the hard compound tyres. I don't know who Prime Scorer is in the McLaren Honda. Definitely not a name I've seen before. But he's fairly low down the grid. However, I don't think he qualified, but he is in 15th. So he's above Nick and Chicane. Let's have a look at the Constructors' Championship, as it's probably quite a good time to have a look. You can see the battle from second all the way down to sixth is extremely close. It's anyone's game, and Alex has just got one position. He's not going to make up two positions. Is that Fizzy ahead of him? I think it probably is, yeah. One runner's pulled out a little bit of a gap. Now, Tirano's still in the lead. By how much, though? Not much. He's definitely within the DRS range of Afro. He's obviously extremely quick round here. He might just have had quite a bit of luck in the races he has participated in. Like I said earlier, that's Belgium. Is it Belgium? No, it's... Germany, Belgium, Italy and Singapore are races he's participated in. And that's earned him enough 4 points. 6 points even. So yeah, let's hope he can improve on that. He might even be able to get a race win. I mean, Tirano's been the most dominant I've ever seen anyone on a single game. He is a PS4 champion. He's champion on PC. Will he decide to go to Xbox? If he has an Xbox, I'm not sure if he does. If he has an Xbox, will he attempt to become a champion next season? However, Afro's went in, probably for the undercut. Now, what tyre is he going to go on? It looks like Nick B has also came in. So... let's have a look. What tyre does Nick go on to? In fact, no, we want to have a... oops. Oh, no. He's went on the hard compound tyres. Nick B's went on to the soft compound tyres. Oh, no, he hasn't. Nick B is on the... is that the hard compound tyres? Yes, it is. Probably trying a two-stop then, I can only imagine. The tyres are going in with no people. They're just floating into the garage. GG Codemasters. Fizzy has also obviously came into the pits. A lot of drivers have came into the pits. It seems like, wow, a lot of the drivers actually from 12th down seem to come onto the pits. Alex, now, this is interesting. Alex is in third place and he hasn't stopped, nor does he need to. I don't know how long the hard tyres last, but I imagine it's a good, I don't know, 15-ish laps. Let's go towards the front of the grid, where Tirano is. He's in very much no man's land. Nonrun's just 6 seconds behind. This is a break Nonrun needs. Of course, Tirano is on the medium compound tyres, so we probably won't see him come until about lap 10. If he comes in now, I'd be very surprised. No, he doesn't. So, oh, hang on, my mouse has gone a bit weird. I've got this Autobot and it blocked some messages. Well, Raven, you say Tigger's gone. I wouldn't necessarily agree with you at this stage. The two drivers behind are going to get one almighty undercut. That is, of course, Nick B and Afro, who's already overtaken Chicane. And in fact, how much traffic have these guys got? Quite a bit. So he's got to get past Prime Scorer. Marco is not very happy with his early incident. Has a video up on YouTube if you guys want to have a look at that. I'll put a link in the chat if it's something you guys do want to have a look at. There's rain at the end of a race. Even if there is rain at the end of a race, I think I'd probably do what Afro and Nick B has done. Starting off very fast, getting an undercut, getting on hard compound tyres, then it's about holding up Tirano. Maybe Tirano's going to do a double medium. It depends how much at the end of a race. I didn't see, so if you would be able to inform me on when that rain's meant to come. Let's just check that Tirano isn't in the pits. No, he isn't. Alex is still out. He's 12 seconds behind, obviously meaning Nonrunner has came into the pits. Nonrunner, he's quite far back now. He's ahead of Fizzy. But behind Nooker. Wow, we got quite a battle behind, which includes, oh. Includes East End, Massachusetts, and Nally, I thought. Well, they were very close. Not as close anymore. He's trying to do one stop less. Raven's obviously a former, maybe he still is, but I know he's he was a former AOR driver, very much a veteran. He's very much more involved in Rocket League, and talking about Rocket League, if you want to join any AOR league of, you know, and there's quite a selection. It's Forza, Dirt, F1, Project Cars, Rocket League. They've even done non-racing games or non-car games in the past, such as FIFA and also iRacing, notably. Please do visit www.apexonlineracing.com. They'll give you the link to the website and a full list of all the various disciplines AOR do, and they're adding to it all the time. Massachusetts, not doing too bad. He's in third place. Ooh, Gillen's losing time from Tirano, who hasn't stopped yet, nor has Gillen. Neither of them have. I imagine Alex will be recording and uploading his POV after the race, doing a commentary and whatnot. It's a shame Ryan's had to sit out this race. I mean, you know, he's obviously a very quick driver, and when he's on form, he's definitely a solid midfield driver. Probably from fifth down to 10th, and he can consistently get points. He's a very consistent driver. Obviously, he's played things like sims like iRacing and R Factor in the past. iRacing, obviously, he's quite competent when it comes to oval racing with the IndyCar and stuff. So he's got a lot of knowledge of different cars. Tirano's into the pits. What tyre is he going to go on? I can only assume the hard compound tyre. We'll find out. Yes, it is the hard compound tyre. So, is Gillen going to be in the pits? No, he isn't. Alex is leading a Grand Prix for the first time since this time last year. The reason AOR was not doing R Factor Leagues, I can't exactly tell you the exact reasons. It might just be because of interest. There's a big following on iRacing as well. But I've played R Factor 2 and I do have the sim. And you're right, it is a lot better. It's quite good fun. You know, obviously all the mods and stuff, it's a lot more moddable than something like iRacing. I would imagine I imagine R Factor 2, they might have done a couple of one-off races, like maybe 24-hour races and stuff they might have done. I'd be interested to see when Alex does come into the pits, but he could lead a whole racing lap if he crosses the start-finish line in first and doesn't get overtaken by Massachusetts. I'm interested to see where Tirano has came out though. Is Alex coming into the pits? I imagine he won't until a little later on. No, he doesn't. Let's have a look closer to the back of the grid. No, Tirano is ahead of Suo Biss, I'm guessing. Yeah, Suo Biss. Nick has retired from the race. You might know him as Nick No Name or Nicky FD. He was very quick. He has been very quick in the past. He's always been split one vote. He was teammates with me in season 10, I think it was, or season 11. Can't really remember. In fact, I don't even know what season we are now. I think we're... Oh, season 12, yeah. So season 10, Nick was teammates with me. Oh, well, I'm sorry to break your heart, Ryan. I mean, obviously, you know, not many of you will know, but Ryan is a former Xbox champion. He was able to beat Noble on multiple occasions on the Xbox and was able to get the championship in season 1, 2, 3, and 4. Don't search that up, though. I'm sure Ryan would appreciate it. Afro's not too far behind Tirano, however he is under pressure by Nick B. These two cannot be separated, but Afro and Nick B have been close all race long. Tirano set at 137. Does that mean that Tirano is going to win the race? Well, probably. Alex has came into the pits as well. He's on the hard compound, medium compound tyres, sorry. He's an eighth when he... came into when he was before everyone pitted. He's now in 12th. Lost quite a bit of time, but he will be very, very quick. So he's obviously got a Sergio Perez helmet. Busy's in 10th. He's had a good season, actually, Fizzy. He's impressed me, to be honest. He's third in the drivers, and I think well deserved. Xbox of late, well, at least I'm not going to say not so much anymore, but some of the ultra quick drivers Well, TRL Limitless, or JD, he hasn't been too quick this season. He's had a lot of bad luck and just, in general, just hasn't been that quick, to be honest. Obviously, Matt and Harry, they've both, well, retired or they're taking a long sabbatical, you know. But Fizzy's been there since the beginning of ARL. Has had a good season, though. Fizzy's had 3 podiums. Had a 4th place, quite a few 5ths and 6ths. He's only had 1 DNF. In fact, I apologise, Fizzy has also had a 2nd place. That was a non-runner, got a DNS. But you can never take away a win, podium, or anything like that from a driver. It's so difficult, the talent is so high. Everyone practices a lot, so. Nonra's only 12 seconds behind the leader. Who is the leader? Is it Tyranno? No, it isn't. Massachusetts is currently leading all the hard compound tires. I can only assume he hasn't pitted. No, he hasn't. A couple of drivers haven't pitted, actually. Chicane hasn't pitted yet. I feel he's been quite lucky. Chicane's must have had an incident or something like that. He might have had the, was he the one who had the incident with Marco? No, that was Marek. Now, Tyranno's going to be getting the DRS, and whoa, he really pushed. In fact, is he coming into the pits? That's probably lightly, actually. Yes, it is. The reason you would know Massachusetts is coming into the pits is because he was trying desperately hard not to go to the right-hand side. Well, we know from that Massachusetts and the other drivers who haven't pitted, the tires probably last about 13 full Grand Prix laps. Yes. They would have all been outside the top 10 because they wouldn't have qualified on those tires. So, not too bad. It'll be interesting to see how Massachusetts gets on. He's midfield. He joined Austria, but he's had a few solid results. He's very much midfield. He's only had two races, well, one race outside of the points. One was the DNS. The other one was at the Temple of Speed in Monza. So, yes, he's been quite good. Let's talk about Onage joining today, but he isn't for whatever reason. Can I? Oh my god, I think I can actually drive. Let's not do that. Just in case I start driving, because, you know, I mean, I'd probably win, but, you know, we need to give other people a chance. I was half thinking about doing some practice with Marco and Tyranno earlier on. Oh, what a camera shot. I love that. I'm doing some practice with Tyranno and Marco earlier today. Me and Marco are on a Skype call, and he asked me if I wanted to join, but my wheel wasn't plugged in, and I've got all my flight simulation stuff plugged in, which, to be honest, is a bit of a nightmare to move. I mean, it would only take about 5 minutes. It's just, yeah. See, Fizzy in 5th, not too bad at all. He's been really consistent this season. I think this is probably his best season ever in league racing. I don't believe he ever got a win on Xbox. Don't hold me to that. I don't believe he has. But has Fizzy ever had a win in AOR? Ryan, you'd probably be able to tell me because you've obviously raced with Fizzy a lot. Yeah, obviously, only just FSR which is like the kind of FSR, if you don't know, is a very highly rated R factor sort of season, a very high simulation. You know, they have things like race mechanics, they have live coverage, just in his own I was gonna say Jerome, but whatever you call it. Justin is drones, like race, what's it called? Race director, I guess it's race director. But, I mean, Ownage is unbelievably quick on all racing games. He's one of the drivers who would probably give Tirano a run for his money. I would imagine Ownage is probably quite quick in a go-kart or something like that as well in real life. Afro is 8 seconds behind, and Nick B is not far behind him, just to get an extra couple of seconds. A little bit more than the pit stop, but 8 seconds after 16 laps is only about half a second a lap, so it's not too bad. Oh, he's went really, really wide! He's managed to hold it though. Very lucky indeed. You obviously don't want to have an incident. You don't want to have an incident then. And he's came into the pit. I imagine he hasn't got any. Ooh, let's hope he stopped in time. I froze into a pit. Is Nick B also into a pit? Yeah, they seem to be on the same strategy now. He's on the medium compound tyres. And I'm surprised Nick B's went on to the hard compound tyres. What if it will change? No, it hasn't. Let's have a look at the race director. That will hopefully give us the real answer. Nope, he is on the medium compound, hard compound tyres even. Where's Afro came out though? All right, behind EZN92. And he's got chicane to negotiate. Oh no, he hasn't. He's got Nally, who's, in a battle with Marek. Red Bull and Torosso going head to head. Should be very quick though, so I imagine Afro is going to be overtaking EZN92 fairly quickly. Reminds me a little bit of TraceMe92, similar kind of name, maybe it is in disguise. That's okay if you don't know what FSR is. Most people wouldn't have heard of it unless they've been involved in the sim racing community or if you're subscribed to Ownage on YouTube. So it's it's very big in R factor if you play that sort of stuff. Avram has dispatched of EZN92. I thought they were streaming live, but I wasn't too sure. I knew they had things like coverage and stuff. I mean, a sim like R-Fact is very, and iRacing is very easy to stream live. But I think that's something that's sort of been built in, and slowly we're getting it in F1 as well. Hopefully, F1 2017 will. Hopefully, F1 2017 will have some even better live features. Hassan third, has he stopped once or twice? I think he's only stopped once, hasn't he? He has. Then so's Tyranno. So quite interestingly, Alex and Tyranno are in the same strategy but alternate. Now, Alex, you can drive through Marco, so don't worry about that. Yep, good job. Nonron's in second place. He's behind me, or lapping me. Good job that our cars do go invisible. Well, 15 seconds behind. Gillen's, what is it, 33? So, just, what's that, difference? 8 seconds. Hmm. Afro said a fastest lap. Not surprising, though, because he is on those fresh tyres. He's in sixth. He's overtaken Marek. Luckily, he didn't have any issues with Marek. In fact, Marek probably let him pass. If this was real F1, Red Bull would be on the team Soros saying, you're going to have to let our driver through ASAP. But now he's also in a battle with Massachusetts. I think these guys are quite close to each other in the championship. Yes, they are very close. In fact, they're on identical points. 34, both of them are on. I apologise that I've had the driver's championship on for ages and ages. Raven, can you tell us a bit more about that? I haven't been. Is that on R Factor or iRacing or R Factor, I guess, or is it anything to do with AOR? Afro's taken Nally. Good job there. Now he's got Massachusetts. He's gonna get the double DRS. In fact, I'd be pretty certain that he's going to get the move done. This DRS, Massachusetts hasn't got the DRS. Afro set another fast lap, 36.8, and well passed into the braking zone. Massachusetts, don't hit him from behind. No, he hasn't. All right, FSR. Oh, nice. Oh, yes, yeah, I think I know what you're talking about. There's a European Championship as well, isn't there, I think? And I think, yeah, I do know what you mean. Yeah, the Ace, the Ace Championships were only just started on a couple of years ago, I think, and he's worked his way up to the top. I believe some of the drivers even get paid on FSR. Don't hold me to that, though, I'm not sure, but it is a very... It's in terms of the sim racing and the sim level, it's basically you will not get any faster drivers in the world on a computer game. That's where you go if you're the world's fastest drivers on a computer game. In terms of F1, I think there are obviously other leagues out there besides AOR, but AOR have every. If a driver is champion on AOR, on their certain platform, it means they are almost definitely the fastest on that platform over a season. So, Kinlan's lost a little bit of extra time. I was interested to see what lap times Tyranno is setting. He's setting 37, sort of, I don't know, 37s to 8s, high 37s and 8s. Alex is 30, high 38s, 39s. And Afro's 36s, 7s, and yeah, so he is definitely gaining ground. Like I said, pit lane lost time is 22 seconds. That's the magic number I'm looking for. Now, Tirano hasn't pitted. Now, I'm not sure when the rain was meant to come. Or he has pitted, but he's only pitted once. I'm not sure when the rain's meant to come. But, 17 to 28. However, Afro is in quite a good position. Unless Tirano has pitted and came out ahead. No, he hasn't. I've got a post which King Kodiak has sent me. I wonder if it's anything interesting. It's on AOR. Right, well, did he go and pro? I remember him saying something about Ace, though. Maybe pros the bottom. Yeah, I think there's three tiers. I think there's a pro, ace, and then one even slightly higher up. Afro is closing in on Alex. Will Alex get a podium? That'll be quite a triumph, I think. He's obviously still got some form of motivation for the game. I mean, he has done a full career season on his YouTube channel. I recommend you do go and check out his videos. He provides good commentary and he's very quick. So, he's obviously got some motivation. He is one of the beta testers. I'm not sure if he'll be in the 2017 beta. I know they have, however, you can sign up for the 2017 beta. I don't know if us guys in the 2016 beta will get automatically in. It'd be quite cool though. He's lost a little bit of time and now we're both going into the pits. I haven't seen any rain. Is Tirano in? No, he isn't. So, these guys are going to be going on to soft tyres now. Tirano's pretty much won it. I can't really see. In fact, they're going on to intermediate tyres. Now, is it too early? We all have to find out. Let's have a look at Gillen. He was first coming in. However, he's out behind Afro. So, it'll be interesting to see. Let's get on to broadcast as well. So I think it's probably a little bit too dry though. I mean, normally, you know, it's time to go into inters when you start seeing small puddles on the track. Is it inters or wets? I forgot. As soon as you start aquaplaning, meaning that your steering becomes very much ineffective, that's when you go into the wets. But intermediate tyres is, well, there's a bit of spray coming off. Let's keep an eye on Tirano. Is he into the pits? Yes, he is. He's going to be on the intermediate tyres. He was third. Afro was 30 seconds behind when he originally came out. He's got a little bit sideways there. So, I wonder if he's decreased that. I imagine Nooker is not on the pits. Non-runner is also just coming into the pits now. And so, let's see how far Afro is behind Tirano. It probably it feels like it's probably around 35 to 40 seconds, to be honest. We should get an update about now. 54, that's a false reading. Gosh, Tirano is already at the double. double right-hander. That's pretty ridiculous. Yeah, that is absolutely crazy. I don't know how Toronto's been able to make up that much time. In one lap, it seems it went from about 30 to 35. Okay, I think that's about what I guesstimated anyway, 35 to 40. Still 5 seconds in one lap because of a bit of a poor decision. Most exciting battles, probably for third, actually. Let's have a look through the field, though. He's at 92. He's had a good second race. Like I said last time, he was lucky enough to get points. He was the 10th, won World Championship points. You'd never say no to a single point. It's always important. Fizzy's in 10th. Is he in danger of losing that? Yes, he is. Marek's behind him. Well, Prime score is close. I don't know who he is, though. What nationality is he? He's British. No, he's not on any of the screens, so I imagine he's a recent sign-up. I notice there's a lot of drivers who come in and out all the time of the league. Nook is in the pits. Right, that means Alex is going to get third. Is he going to get promoted to second? Well, only time will tell. After one full lap for Afro, what time did he set? 49 flat. Gillen was a 49.5. Taran, I think he's only done one lap, hasn't he? Yeah. So 208 though, that's matching Afro's out lap, so seem to be similar on pace. In Serrano, there's always been a driver who's been about like a similar pace, but it's never been exact. It's never been the same. It's a shame Marco couldn't still be driving, because he was very quick in qualifying, but he was also very quick in the race, and that's where Marco's most of his pace comes from. You'll see a lot of the time he has a poor qualifying, and he'll end up being very fast in the race. But, you know, it is what it is. You can't always, can't always have it your own way. It's interesting, Marco and Alex are very, very similar in terms of their AOR stats. Probably a similar amount of race to win ratio. Both of them, well, Marco isn't anymore, but he was an undefeated champion, same as Alex. There's only been three, I believe, which is Noble 2909, Alex, and of course Marco, undefeated champion, meaning that, you know, they just have never been beaten over the course of this season. However, that's all changed now, obviously. Obviously, around about this time, the drivers will be looking about to next season. Like their plans, what we decide to do. There's five more races after this. We've got Suzuka, America, Mexico, Brazil, and Abu Dhabi. So, you know, quite exciting. To us, Suzuka, I like America. Mexico's a bit meh, I find. It's just a classic track. Really cool spectacle, I imagine. Extremely high speeds because of a high altitude. The air is thinner. Which is why, I don't know if any of you know, you probably don't, but in an aircraft or something, you know how, you know, they go about 500 to 600 miles an hour normally when they're flying at the high altitudes which they fly at. The reason being is because the air is much thinner. There's no drag slowing them down. Which is why they always go much faster the higher up they are. I mean, an aircraft wouldn't be able to go any faster than about 300 miles an hour near sea level. It'll probably go, I don't know, maybe 320 or something, depending on what sort, but, you know, it wouldn't be nothing major. Let's have a look at physique. See, he was under quite a lot of pressure, and is under a lot of pressure from Merrick. He's going to be driving around the outside. DRS is probably disabled. We'll find out any second now. These drivers, yeah, it is disabled. So, it's driving skill alone now. For the last two Grand Prix laps. Fizzy has only been out of the points once. And that's where he got a DNF in Monaco. Monaco. I can't remember what it's from. I don't think I covered that stream. Probably, most likely from a crash or something like that. But in terms of race finishes, he hasn't been out of the points once. Over 16 rounds, that's pretty impressive. Very impressive actually. I mean, if we look at the driver ahead of him, non-runner, who Fizzy is, theory, can still take. He's only 36 points behind. He got a 14th in Silverstone. No, that hasn't been an amazing weekend for Fizzy. Barely low down and qualifying. I thought he had quite a good strategy slightly earlier on, but obviously it came to nothing during the race. He's looking quite competitive. To be honest, it's kind of been same old. You get quite excited about people like Afro and Nick B possibly challenging Toerano. But Toerano is basically just at least 0.5 of a second faster every single lap. Every single lap, Toerano is half a second faster. Naturally, he's half a second faster. At his best, it's probably even more. And what it means is the strategies vary and the undercut sort of works because the guys behind are able to make up a half second of the lap on the fresher tyres than Toerano. But then, eventually, when it all comes to the end, Toerano's about half a minute ahead. But hey, it is what it is. Toerano is going to be across the line. He's going to be our winner once again. Great job from him. It's a record amount of wins. For Toerano Tigger. Is it 14? Sorry, 13 or 14. Afro's going to come second. Good job from Gillen is going to come third. Not bad at all. He hasn't done a whole season. He doesn't really know the cars. Probably hasn't got an optimal setup. He might have had a couple of pints anyway. We don't know. But he's, very good job. I'm pleased for him. Nally. Let's have a look at this view. Nally's under pressure from non-runner, who's not going to get him. Oh, very close. Oh, no. I don't think I can change. Driver, come on. Nooker. Got Marek. Now, is Fizzy going to get Marek? No. For first time this season, Fizzy's out of points. Prime scorer is in 12th. Marco comes across a line to finish in 17th, although it is just an AI drive. Oh my gosh, what happened there? That looked quite exciting. Well, Alex did not get a podium. He is down. Alex is, without trying to suggest anything, it's probably for track limits. We'll have to find out. Probably is for track limit, so he got a penalty on 26. Unlucky on the intermediate tires as well. Sorry for the lag. It's one of the things of this of the type of lobby we have up, because we're on a beta version of the game, or testing version even. Non-runner in fifth. Well, Natalie got a third place. Not bad at all. Good job from him. Has his best result so far this season. Good job from Natalie. But Natalie hasn't really got close to the podium at all. That's going to put a distance from him in Massachusetts. It's going to elevate him probably above Chicane and close to Mini Black. In fact, probably above Mini Black. So good job from him. Well done. Well done. So, that has been round 16, the Malaysian Grand Prix. I want to thank you guys very much for watching. I think I'll be streaming next week from this channel as well. Join me next time on this channel. I'll have to confirm that with King Kodiak. Thanks for you guys saying you think I've done a good job. It's quite a bit harder when I'm not, I'm much better at just being the secondary commentator, coming up with the stats, the statistics, for more insight. So if it's just me again, I will try and get another commentator. I'll ask around, see if I can get someone, a profile name, people are likely to know. Maybe Ryan will be able to join us, who knows. But guys, thank you very much for watching Malaysian Grand Prix. Hasn't been the most exciting race. However, Suzuka always provides some exciting racing, being one of the most challenging tracks of the season. Goodbye, and thank you. Ta-ra.